Copyright disclaimer. Under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976, allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news, reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright statute that might otherwise be infringing. Nonprofit, educational, or personal use tips the balance in favor of fair use. Viewer discretion is advised.
Overseas tonight, new threats after that volcanic eruption at a popular Spanish tourist spot in the Canary Islands. Earthquakes rocking the island, a new vent opening up in the mountainside, and fears tonight of toxic gases now when that river of lava reaches the sea. Thousands of families forced to leave, racing to save what they can. Some of those homes already gone. Look at the fire right at the edge of that pool. ABC's James Longman on the island of La Palma tonight.
All praises to the Most High Yahweh, the Heavenly Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, the Earthly Mother, sanctifying Yahushai, the Holy Son. Brothers and sisters, Jews and Gentiles alike, welcome. This is your humble servant, Big Levi, and today is Wednesday, September the 22nd, 2021, and it's currently 12:38 a.m. Peace be with you. Peace be unto you. There will be no Jacob's trouble. There will be none of this garbage. Those people have no power to come towards us or against us. The Most High say, Emmanuel, he is with us. He is in the midst. The Archangel Michael is here. Rejoice, brethren. Rejoice, sistren. Rejoice, Gentiles, cleaving. Rejoice. Be happy. The Most High is visiting the earth now, man. Before we begin, we would like to clear out certain things. One, if you see the videos have any commercial in them, YouTube can do this. They can put any commercial in there, whatever they want to do, that's them. The second thing I want to point out, we want to tell the newcomers, welcome. Thank you for being here. It is good to be here. Okay, once in a while, please come visit us. You do not have to subscribe to our channel. Please don't do this unless your spirit told you to do it, but you don't have to subscribe here. If you just stumble upon this, that's good. Check us once. If we pop up your recommendation or once in a while, or the spirit move you to come over here, you just check it. Now, to all of you newcomers, please stop listening to the Gentiles, the heathens, the Christians, the religious folks out there, the conspiracy theorists out there. The Most High is not talking to them. They are in fear, they are moved, they are vibrated in a low frequency. And if you keep listening to their garbage, they are going to bring you down to their frequency, and then you won't be able to receive the Holy Spirit. You won't be able to receive the holy transmission that the Most High is sending upon our people. I repeat, if you are if you are somewhat following certain people online right now that are keep bringing the garbage about the mark of the beast and the rapture and all that nonsense, I will highly suggest you not to follow this person. I know the people that have been here for quite some time, they already know the Most High is, of course, in the midst, and everything that happening here is happening by the power of the Most High. Men do not have the power to do these things that you're about to witness through those videos that we have here. Men has no power to depopulate the entire earth. The so-called elite has no power to do this. They are not God, nor gods, nor fallen angels. They are regular human, like, well, if anything, they are freaking demons. They just like a bunch of blummer. They know nothing. They are a bunch of poor people. What you're calling Bill Gates is a poor man, a broke man. What you're seeing is a front. He's not that smart. Stop giving this man the glory that the Messiah deserve. Beloved, Jews, Gentiles alike, we are going to go through those videos and witness the Messiah's wrath and witness the Messiah's work and witness the angels coming back unto us and report. Let us begin.
Strange.
Wait a minute, is that thing even recording? Let me see. Boy, I see that great stuff. There we go. It is recording. All right, let's go.
This volcanic island is still roaring tonight, and now authorities are alarmed at another series of earthquakes opening up new fissures today. An unstoppable wall of lava is eating everything in its path. Superheated molten rock sizzling as it hits this swimming pool. Neighborhoods incinerated. A further 2,000 evacuations from La Palma, which is just off the coast of North Africa, meaning more than seven.
Really? Really? You got to be freaking kidding me. Yo, you people are running away from this thing. You grabbing a washing machine. Is that what that is? As if you cannot replace. You guys are grabbing mattresses and then all this stuff. Okay, all right, as if they belong to you. Okay, let's go then.
7,000 have now had to flee their homes, some in
tears. Look at this. This is plague number one and number two. Look at this.
With only an hour's notice to take everything they could.
Now, beloved brothers and sisters, Jews and Gentiles, look at this. Whew. All right, Jews and Gentiles alike. Is this image that you're looking in, right? Let me enlarge this so our people that have low visibility can see this. And for those of you that can't see, let me explain this to you. Now, let me read this for those of you who already see what's going on here. You already see the perfection of the Most High. Developing now, mass volcano evacuations. 7,000 flee for safety. All praises to the Most High. Neighborhoods incinerated. All praises to the Most High. Yay. When that thing did happen over there in St. Vincent, when our people were there, yes, you guys were making fun of them. You were showing our people in distress. Now look at you. Yay. When that thing happened in St. Vincent, it didn't do that much damage. It was much more ashes. Okay, the lava passed, but it did pass in a place that it only damaged a few houses, and the lava, the couple of people that got killed was a fellow, an old man. He didn't even want to leave. He told his wife, I'm not leaving. I can't walk. I can't run. If I leave with you, I will slow you down. Both of us will die. Save yourself. That was his time, and he acknowledged this, and then he did die. Now, with you guys showing our people, and then a lot of people were moved, say Big Levi and stuff, Jacob Strobel. We keep telling you, amen, there'll be no Jacob Strobel. What you are seeing here, brothers and sisters, Jews and Gentiles alike, is this Jacob Strobel? Is this a Jacobite? Is this the typical look of a Jacobite? If this the typical look of an Israelite? If it is not, is this the look of happiness? Is this the look, brothers and sisters, of a person that is ready to guide the entire earth to a new beginning, to a new life, to a thriving economy, to a thriving civilization? Is this the face of a woman? For those of you who are not watching, there's a so-called white woman holding, you know, still she's crying, but still holding to her mattress. Okay, she doesn't want to let that thing go. Okay, she got a bunch of stuff in the back of a little pickup truck Toyota, and she's crying, and her left hand is wiping the tears in her face, and she's crying a lot, and she's fleeing in the back of a car. Is this the face of somebody that say, you know what? Finally, we are about to rule the world. Finally, the new world order is going to come. It's going to be my people, and then we're going to rule. Finally, we are going to get those damn Igbo Israelite off the land and take it over. Is that what that is? Beloved brothers and sisters, I want you to watch this. Stop listening to people that try to put fear into you. Watch what the Most High is doing. Before we move and proceed, this is plague number one also. Excuse me. Plague number one, sorrow for much needs, shortages. As you can see, beloved, the shortages, we're going to see. We have our beloved sister, Lisa Cabrera, peace be upon her. She has one of the video where police department is in shortages of bullets. We'll get in there. But sorrow. What is sorrow, beloved brothers and sisters? We do this once in a while. All the time we do this. Define sorrow.
Here's the definition of sorrow. A feeling of deep distress caused by loss, disappointment, or other misfortune suffered by oneself or others.
Sadness, unhappiness, dejection, regret, depression, misery. Brothers, this is the face of misery. This is the face of dejection. This is the face of unhappiness. This is the face and the spirit of sorrow. Plague number one. Plague number two. Fiery conflagration of the cities. Okay, let's define this word. I don't know that word. Define fiery. Oh, no, wait. That's not what I meant. Okay, hang on. Define conflagration.
Here's the definition of conflagration. An extensive fire which destroys a great deal of land or property.
Fire, blaze, flames, inferno, firestorm, and holocaust. You know, I like saying inferno, okay? So I would say, you know, I usually bring a bunch of trash with me when I'm doing this thing. But anyway, an extensive fire which destroys a great deal of land and property. What you are seeing here, brothers, what you just witnessed here, what you're about to finish witnessing here, this is a great fire that are destroying a bunch of property, a bunch of people. And then it sees the 10 plagues of the apocalypse of Abraham. All of those things are happening, brothers and sisters. They're happening because of Genesis 15, verse 13. And he said unto Abram, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them. And they shall afflict them 400 years. Yea, we did fulfill from 1619 to 2019 our 400 years. Yea, indeed, when you come here in the fourth part in our holy land, you put your filthy feet in our holy land over there in the island known as Haiti, where we have our holy temples over there. And then you swagger jack our land. You go in Mexico. You go in the so-called North America, Canada, all over the U.S., the true Jerusalem, the true promised land. This land will not be destroyed. The people will be destroyed. The land didn't do anything to us. Oh, America will be destroyed because America is evil. No, the system, the people will be destroyed because the system and the people is evil. The land is not evil. Africa will not be destroyed. We own this entire earth. Yay, we did serve slavery all over the world. And then now, because we fulfilled this prophecy, Genesis 15, verse 14, and also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge, and fathers judging this nation. You think you can go over there and hide on this little island called St. Michael Island, and then think the Most High is not going to find you? Hmm? So are you one of those preppers that go over there and hide? Oh, I'm going to go live off-grid. Whenever the grid go down, the hedge go hit the fan, I will survive. I will have food. I will have guns and ammo and stuff. I will survive. So why don't you use your gun and shoot the lava? Why don't you use your gun and shoot the magma? Why don't you use your bullets and shoot the volcano? Huh? Is that what that is? Better yet, why don't you befriend with the gamma and then the magma and give it some food that you've been storing? Huh? Why don't you try reason with it? You think you can hide from the face of the Father of creation? I am the Most High God. I created the heaven. I rule the earth. And I will not share my glory with another. You think you can hide from me? You think you can go and dig a little bug out location and then hide there in a little hole you call your bunker? Oh, it cost me $50, $60, $100 million. I'm going to be safe here. Sir, have you ever heard of the Sulanuf? Have you ever heard of the Leviathan? Have you ever heard of the Behemoth? You think you can escape from the Mosai? What's going on here? It is not done by men, nor men are in control. There's no such thing. The elite is in control. Now, beloved brothers and sisters, now we know the Mosai is then the mist. We established this with scriptures and definition. Let us move in.
An hour's notice to take everything they could. In an area reliant on agriculture, 300 farms turned to ash.
You heard that? 300 farms burned to the ground. Where are you going to get your food? And then this will bring plague. This will bring plague number 4. Famine of the world. Gentiles walls. You stuck on this island. Okay, the Mosai say destruction by pestilence among the cattle. Okay, he will send pestilence among your cattle. That is why all those birds are falling off the skies. That is why the fire, the magma, the lava is a pestilence. Okay, and 8 is ravaging the world right now. Pestilence and hunger will change their destruction. The destruction of the Gentiles, okay? Pestilence and hunger will change the destruction. That means the Mrs. Wona and the hunger you're going to fight will totally change your destruction. And it is being done in the name of the horrible and terrible God that we worship in our heart, the Most High himself, Yahweh.
I've never seen anything like this.
No, of course
not. We're just a few hundred feet from the actual volcano. It's just one of the fissures is just there. I'm not sure if you can tell, but we are being rained on with ash. It's just extraordinary. If I show you down here, this is the stuff that's coming down.
All this moving towards the ocean. And when the 1800 degree lava hits the water...
How many degree was the lava? You know what? Let me drink a little water. Oof. 1800 degrees. Drink a little water. Let the people do their thing. Let the people give the Most High glory here, man. Yeah. Destruction. Let us keep on moving.
Thermal shocks may release clouds of toxic gas and acid rain. Mm-hmm. Another natural disaster for this scarred island to battle.
Just spectacular images tonight. James Longman with us live from the island of La Palma. And James, we're looking at the volcano right there behind you.
Yeah, you can see lava and hot ash still shooting up into the night sky. But what officials were really worried about is happening. Streams of lava, rather than heading to the ocean, are now heading inland, which is causing further destruction.
Who can do this? Who's doing this? You see, the Gentiles have their little devices. And then what they do, brothers, when they connected their little technology, they always predict, okay, well, this thing will happen, but fear not. The lava will flow to the ocean. We just need to evacuate it, 5,000 people. And the first day, I believe, and they predicted in one area where this is the slope area where the lava they predicted that was going to pass, aka the magma. I'm not quite sure. forgive me. I believe when it's underground, they call it lava. When it's above ground, they call it magma. Can somebody double check that or vice versa? But whatever it is, they predicted that the lava would have go that way. So they evacuated 5,000 people. Now you just read it. They evacuated an additional 7,000. Now, brothers and sisters, I'm not too good with mathematics or arithmetics. If what is the magical number here if you add 7,000 plus 5,000? The 5,000 they evacuated the other day plus the 7,000 they evacuated today. Let me give you 10 little second while I hydrated the holy temple with the Holy Spirit. This is good. I don't wanna make so much noise because the kids are asleep. And sometimes the wife come in and open the door. She say, "You all right? I can hear you from the room." You know, I'm very loud. And I mean, to me, it's 12:56 a.m. when I will pre-record this too. You'll probably be still 9 o'clock or 8:45 or whatever. I don't want to check this. I got to check this, man. Okay, probably still it's 40-something. So, all right. All right, beloved brothers and sisters, let us keep on moving.
And officials worry that this could go on for weeks. David?
All right, James.
This could go on for weeks. Man, September is a hell of a month. And we still have 8 or 9 more days left. Is that what that is? 8 days? We still got 8 days left. For those of you who remember, give the Most High glory and praises when we had that conflagration fast. When we were praying, we said, Father, bring the Holy, bring the burial, bring Uriel, and make them performing that dance recital, especially in that house that is not black. We're still waiting, though, but we are quite satisfied with this. All right, fellow, I think these guys are done. Let's read the comment a little, see what's going on here. Another Pompeii, I'll need to leave now. This is how the volcano forming the island. Why would people move to inactive? For those people that are saying, okay, but why would the people move to a volcano like this inactive? Listen, they never move to this place because, oh, it's for vacations, because there's a powerful ley line over there. Everywhere there is volcano, it's a powerful ley line. In our old videos, we study, we understand that volcanoes are very powerful, if not the most powerful ley lines. If volcano are probably the most powerful terrestrial ley line. That is why they have a volcano over there in Mississippi and Jackson, Mississippi, under the Coliseum. Okay, volcano are very powerful. The so-called capital, the capital hill that they have in the White House, they are aligned with the Devil's Tower and multiple volcanoes. This, if somebody can do this, if you trace this island, I don't want to open Google Earth. If you trace this island, I can guarantee you it is sending a powerful ley line, whether it's in the White House or somewhere. This island has to do, if you trace it, you can probably see something here. Because if I open Google Chrome, I open Google Earth, it will be too much power in this little computer. I bought this damn thing in 2017, so it's been 4 years, still working. We still have a brand new computer. It's not a problem with the computer, it's just us, you know, we love this computer. I got so much crap in there. Okay, let us keep on moving. All right, let's read some more comment. Okay, that's why those people on this island, brothers, they are sucking up the energy. That's all. Just as the Holy Bible predicted is happening. Repent, believe, obey, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Who's this? Who's doing this? Repent, believe, obey. Okay, all right then. Trish Herbert. Okay. My prayer with you all. Hopefully that volcano will stop flowing. Prayers to God for deliverance from all this natural disaster. What is this? Well, no wonder your name is Maxine West. Those victims all near volcano need to have masks also. They don't breathe the ash deadly. But the land was priced right. What did you think was going to happen? Building a house on the island with an active volcano ley line. They weren't there because of this. They were care for the energy. They were building the stuff there to suck up on the energy. But people don't. You guys don't know that. But all right. When is the landslide into the ocean going to cause this massive tsunami that will cause a 50 war? That's Gentile garbage. They like to, you know, say garbage. We don't care about them. Okay. Party time and the end times. Okay. Well, go ahead. Mark the Most High. Volcanic lava. Is there another kind? Yes. Magma. Okay. I mean, it might sound a bit Hollywood, but couldn't they use maybe some heavy equipment and barrier the steel with a little bit, or maybe get ahead of the flow, use some careful place dynamite and build a channel to divert the flow? I hope these people are able to recover this, stay safe. No, they cannot. I mean, it might sound a bit Hollywood, that is because it is Hollywood. You see, beloved Gentiles, they successfully successfully lie and condition the entire world that they can do anything. They can stop every disaster. Now, there is a movie on Netflix, beloved. I think on Hulu. It's called Volcano, all right? Is it on Hulu? Let me see if I got it here. Oh, Hulu. They might showing it. They might showing it like black. Let me see. It's called Volcano by Volcano. Whoops. Volcano. Is that what that is? Tommy Lee playing in it. Let me see if I can pull the data up right quick. All right. Well, Hulu doesn't want to hold it, but Volcano, Tommy Lee.
Volcano is a 1997 movie directed by Mick Jackson, starring Tommy Lee Jones, Anne Heche, and Gabby Hoffman.
This movie, I watched this movie when I was a kid. I was like 8 years old. Magnificent movie. You need to watch this movie again. I believe it's in Hulu, probably Netflix, I believe. This movie, I'm gonna watch it again. And this movie deal with racism, it deal with the whole volcano, and it shows you how those people combat this volcano. This is Hollywood. Okay, this is Hollywood. This movie was well made. And then as you can see now, I seen this. This is an angel in the midst of this. Okay, there was a volcano, I believe somewhere in West Coast and California. And I'm sensing that they are doing this. They are probably doing the thing for Memphis, Jackson City. Is that what that is? Memphis. Jackson City, Mississippi. You know, so they say there was a volcano there. A beautiful movie, brothers. Beautiful, beautiful movie. Tommy Lee. They show you how they battled the volcano. They won. There was racist. The cap, like, took a black man, abused the black man. This black man was, like, the strongest mofo that they ever seen. He literally lift up a giant freaking barrier. He blocked the volcano, saving the Gentiles and all that. That's what they were teaching our people. But this isn't Hollywood, man. This is reality, and you cannot stop the Messiah's wrath. Your little technology, your little devices have no match for the Messiah power. Again, this is plague number 2, fiery conflagration of the cities. Let us keep on moving, brethren. Oops. Let me see. I will put this right here. Okay. All right, now this dude, his name is Bushcraft Bear. Okay, so I don't really, again, like I said before, brothers and sisters, I don't really like to do those guys, those little YouTubers. Okay, so they are there. It's not like I'm swagger jacking them, but I'm just doing this. I don't like to take those things because they work hard to do this. Okay, but let's take a minute of this.
Hello, my dear viewers. This is Bushcraft Bear speaking to you live from the Canary Islands, La Palma. It's the third day of the volcano eruption. Over there you can see and hear the volcano. Down there are the city lights from the city Los Llanos. I can tell you it's very scary at the moment. The volcano is very huge now.
You hear that, brothers? You hear that thunder? Okay, this is also plague number 10. Okay, thunder voices and destroying earthquake. All of them are happening over there. And those people, it's scary, man. This thing is going, that is scary. The volcano is going bigger and bigger. Live news from the Canary Island, La Palma, okay?
Scientists said a couple hours ago that at the moment there is the strongest activity of the volcano since this started. It started on the 19th of September at about 3 o'clock. I was outside. I had my backpack ready to go for a little hike. And
this is like a classic Gentiles right there. Go hiking where, man? You know, you guys can't feel the ley line, man. Whatever.
Then I heard this noise like a thunderstorm.
Listen, brothers, you say what? You listen to what he said. He said he heard the noise like a thunderstorm. Okay, we all know what that is. He heard that boom, that thunderstorm.
Ready to go for a little hike, and then I heard this noise like a thunderstorm. I looked to the south and I saw a big big cloud, smoke, and immediately I was alarmed. So I told every family members, volcano, volcano. I looked at everybody that we are together. I told all my neighbors, volcano activity. Some of my neighbors didn't recognize it yet. Others already knew it. And yeah, I was a little bit afraid because I never experienced something like that.
And you will always, for at least 1,000, experience things. These things like that will be so new to you. It will be so, you'll be used to things like this, and it will happen every day. You know, you really won't be scared anymore. We are speaking from experience here. Thank you, fellow Bearcraft or Bear Bush or whatever that is. Okay, let us move to the next history.
Here we go.
So this thing is in Portuguese. So we're just going to put this right here. Well, you know what? Let's just mute this. So brothers, look at this. This is the volcano. Look at the magma. Look at the lava moving in. Okay, I will call it lava because it's above ground. Look at the lava, brothers. Look at this. How on earth you going to have some kind of like dynamite? You build some trench and stuff. Do you know what that is, beloved brothers and sisters? You can see faces. You can see all sort of things in here. This cannot be done by men. Men has no power to do something like this. This can only be done by the Most High God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Okay, Civil Guard. That's a funny name. Okay. All right, brothers. Look at the mountain of lava. How are you going to fight this? How? How, beloved? So you're going to bring one of those bulldozer, and push that thing? Is that what that is? Is that what you people want to do? Fight the Most High with your little devices? Solova always told you, like, you know, you can't fight the Most High with your little devices, you know? All right? So, yeah, all praises, okay? All praises to the Most High, all right? Let us move, brothers. You can't fight the Most High like this. Let's go. Okay, look at this. Look at this pool. Look at how the pool is boiling, brothers. Look at this. Wow. The water is boiling and the pool is being filled up by the lava that is coming, man. How are you going to escape this? So you mean, brothers, can you imagine if you are quote-unquote so-called Gentiles and you have a little bunker bug out location, and then you dig a hole in this bunker, you stay over there underground, and you have a pile of magma like this over you? Can you imagine yourself feeling the heat, like the temperature rising, and you cannot open and flee? What you gonna do, bad boys? What you gonna do? You gonna increase, or for the lack of better term, are you going to decrease your AC to 50 degrees? Is that what that is? You and your little bug out location and get under the little bunkers and then I'm surviving, man. I got gold and silver and food and guns and ammos, and then a giant pile of volcano lava on top of you, and then you being cooked in there alive. Got this. Only the Most High, brothers. No one can do this. This thing is covering the pool. The water's boiling. Okay? This thing is covering houses. Look at this. The whole pool is boiling. Look at the water, man. Look at this. Oh, wow. No, that's another pool. That's another place. Okay? The trees are catching on fire. Okay? This is like a little river they have there. Okay? This thing just drying up the river. Okay? All right? You see, they got this. Is that a dam or a river? Okay. look at this. This thing is overpowering the little river, the little canal they have there. Well, it's not a river. It's like a canal, man. All praises to the Most High, man. We give the Most High praises and glory. Let's see if we can have a little bit of the comment. See what's going on. Sorry to see you guys lose your home. Hope all your life. Again, this is plague number 2. Fiery conflagration of the city, brothers. The Most High is destroying those people and sweeping them off the land, aka the entire earth. And, you know, that's the only way, you know, to have peace around this earth. I feel so sorry for all the people whose homes have been destroyed. All their hard work and sacrifice gone. Mm-hmm. The Age of the Drones, great footage. I live in the Canary Island and I feel bad for everyone's home, but at least nobody died. Hopefully the volcano from Lanzarote doesn't erupt. I don't want to leave. Of course you don't want to leave Ireland. Okay, there's another volcano over there, Lanzarote. Only the Most High knows. And we all want and work for big houses, swimming pool, etc. And then there was nothing. Yeah, that's what that is. You really do forget sometimes just how explosive the reaction can be when lava and water meets great drone footage. So, okay, when it's above ground, it's lava. When it's under, it's magma. All right. It must be devastating to watch your home go like this. You have no idea. How awful for all those people who have lost not just their home, but the land upon which they stood. No hope of rebuilding there, unlike other natural disaster. Well, they don't own this home. Okay, they don't want it. Okay, all right. All praises to the Most High, beloved brothers and sisters. Those people in sorrow. That's why they let those Haitians get there, so they can distract you, and so you won't see the Most High's wrath. Okay, we receive the holy transmission. We will not be moved nor be dismayed here. All praises to the Most High. Next.
Technology.
Okay.
Edna's right. Eruption.
So, now, this is I don't want to check this. I know it's recording, but Etna exploded, the most powerful volcanic eruption in Italy. This happened a couple of days ago. So that's another volcano in Italy, brothers. That's a you got volcano all around the world are erupting. Okay? They are erupting. Eruption. Okay.
Sicilian volcano Etna, the largest active in Europe.
I freaking despise those voice things. But one in Italy, all over the world. The one in Greenland, still, brethren. Still. And then people thinking like this is a game. Oh, the elite are doing this. The elite are doing that. The elites. Bill Gates is doing. Get out of here, man. You're dismayed. Okay, so this is in Australia. 6.2 magnitude earthquake rattles Southeast Australia, damaging buildings. Okay.
Good evening here from Washington. On the way in from the airport, we learned of the earthquake which has occurred in Mansfield in Victoria. Geosciences.
All praises, brothers and sisters. I want you to make a mental note and send a quick mental prayer for our beloved brothers and sisters down there in Australia. We know the Most High is protecting them. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for protecting our brethren and sisters and the island of Australia, the beloved brother that always call us, B1 Queensland, and all our people in Australia. All right? All praises. Selah, so be it. Raviel, carry this to the Most High. All praises.
Provide us with the advice record of 6 with aftershocks at 5.5, 4, and 4. I've been in contact with Premier Andrews as well as the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister McKenzie, and we'll continue to receive reports as, throughout the night. Of course, that first response has obviously been provided by the Victorian government, but of course the federal government stands by through Emergency Management Australia to provide whatever assistance is needed, whether from the ADF or others. But at this stage, we have had no reports of serious injuries or worse, and that is very good news, and we hope that good news will continue. But
This cannot be. How is this good news? How are you people? You guys don't understand. This is plague number 5, of course. Okay. Destruction by earthquake. Okay. And also plague number 10. Thunder voices and destroying earthquake. Okay. Plague number 5. Destruction by earthquakes. Okay. So this is not. How is it? Because nobody didn't die? You have no idea.
But obviously, we'll get further reports as the night unfolds here in the United States. But it can be a very, very disturbing event for an earthquake of this nature. They are very rare events in Australia, and as a result, I'm sure people would have been quite distressed and disturbed by that, particularly in the most immediate area affected.
Beloved, this dude just says something here that triggers something in me. He said things like that are very rare in Australia, yet they keep happening all over the world. We told you. Did you know that scientists, when they look in their little devices, it is said that if an earthquake is 7.0 and above, if it happened, let's say, today's September the 22nd, 2021, the next one is predicted to happen 100 years from now. Therefore, the next one should be able to happen somewhere around September the 22nd, 2121. And then they are seeing them happen almost every day. Okay, they don't understand. Well, at least they pretend not to understand. But this is all the Most High, okay? We give the Most High praise, glory for everything that he is doing, okay? All right, let us keep on moving. Oh, and you know, when this guy say, okay, well, you know, things like that rarely happen, and then you know, we don't want to disturb and then put the people. No, this is the Most High. What you're seeing here, brothers, is the fast of the disband and dissolve. Okay, the Most High is disbanding those people, okay? He's dismantling the government. All praises
to
okay, this dude is dismayed.
Oh, I've never had an earthquake in here before.
Okay, so they never had that before. This is something new to them. This is an earthquake, brothers. And you see how those... Let's watch this again, okay? All right? This dude was about to say something, and the Most High coming, okay? Let me drink some water while the people is doing their thing here, okay? Because the people already know who is in the midst. Literally, brothers and sisters, every single video that we make, the Most High is in the midst. Drink some water here. Hydrating the holy temple with the Holy Spirit. All praises. Australian Broadcasting Corporation's Michael Rowland, okay, we'll take the Rao, whoa, the land, and Tony Armstrong, the strong arm of the Most High, where in the studio is, or where, when the earthquake hit. Brothers, you cannot make this up. You can't. How are you able to do this, brothers? How many Michael we've been seeing so far? At least I'll say 20. If we've been counting, at least I'll say 20 Michael. That's the Most High saying officially we are in step number 10. And the Archangel Michael is here. That was the last angel to arrive that put the palm trees. So Yahushua can come and the Most High come with the Holy Spirit. The whole family is there. Okay, it's a family reunion, brothers. It's the Most High coming with the Holy Spirit, okay? The angels and the brothers, and then the whole family coming here, put the judgment in here. You ain't gonna do hish. Look at your face, okay? Okay, this guy, he couldn't say anything. Oh, crap, I put that thing on full. Starts gonna drink out everything. Yeah. All right, we give the Most High praise, his glory, brothers. An earthquake, brethren, happened yesterday. Okay, a couple hours from now, the earth moved for me, and the walls, floor, and ceiling. Well, All praises to the Most High. Mother Earth appears to be protesting the lockdowns too. Yeah. Keep doing this scumbag stuff. All Australians, let us rejoice. We are one and free. I'm so glad everyone is okay. I guess you kind of need those trades now, huh? Then Jesus said to them, nation will fight against other nation, kingdom will fight against other kingdoms. There will be a great earthquake, sickness, and other bad things in many places. And some places there will be no food for the people to eat. Terrible things will happen and amazing. You see, nation against nations, kingdom against kingdom. We, as Yasharala, to you people, we are not a nation. And definitely we are not a kingdom. So it is you, some 83 Gentiles. So, Okay. All right, all praises to the Most High. Let us keep on moving.
And witnesses say it was no.
Okay, watch
blast,
this.
Then fire rocks a local street in the middle of the morning. And witnesses say it was no accident. They say a woman set it off, and there's video to prove it. I'm Jason Martinez.
I'm Shayna Humphreys. Let's get right into it. Chris, what can you tell us about this tonight?
Well, neighbors in Logan woke up today to what they thought was a bomb going off on their street. And it pretty much was. An SUV explodes, catches fire, and surveillance video from a home may have captured the person who started it. A charred minivan with a melted front end. Collateral damage from an early morning explosion that rocked this Logan neighborhood.
Damn!
That's what it sounded like about 8:37 Tuesday morning on the 1200 block of...
Okay, why would they blur that person's face? Like, why? It's like you wanted that person to get caught. But anyway, man, fiery conflagration. Let us move on.
West Rockland Street.
All I heard was like a loud explosion, like a loud bang.
Jesse Pham's security camera not only caught the SUV exploding, but the moments leading up to it. Take a look for yourself. A woman is seen walking up to the SUV with what appears to be a red gas can.
I guess, you know, lawsuits.
And I was just inspecting the video, and I seen her like going in, looking around.
Yes, sir. Again, let me drink a little water here, you know, while the people are doing their stuff, and tell me who this guy is. Who's this guy first name is? Jesse Pham. As we all know, brothers, well, for those of you who know, Jesse is the father of David, King David, okay? In the book of the Throne of David, we find out that Jesse was a very wise man. He was very meek, okay? He was the David come out of his loin, and, you know, all the others came out of David. So now we are under the house of David, okay? Jesse, all praises. The Most High is here. Give the Most High praises and glory, man. You can't make that up. Let us keep going.
Around and just like dumping the gas on a car.
Over 10 minutes, the woman is seen walking around the SUV twice with a red can, then another time before that same woman is seen running away from the burning car.
Damn.
Pham's family took this video as the SUV continued to burn. This is what the scene looked like today. His mom's charred minivan she uses for work now sits melted outside their home. Pham is just grateful his four nieces and nephews who live inside had already left for school.
People are just crazy. They're psychos. They have no regards about anybody else.
The ley line is making them crazy, okay? Please stop repeating what the Gentiles are saying. Well, the vax is making them crazy. No, they've been crazy since the Mosai, since 2019. When you watch, you see like the Mosai switch the ley line. All praises to the Mosai, man, okay?
That lives around here and the things that goes on, nobody cares.
Okay, so all right, fiery that was plague number two. Demons are out there, brothers. Fiery conflagration of the cities. Okay, we give the Most High praise and glory for doing this. Big boom fire. All right, then.
Breaking overnight, an Orange County home badly damaged after an early morning fire. This is video from the scene right along Sansevieria Lane off of Goldenrod Road. Firefighters say it appears the fire started in the kitchen and no one was hurt, but a crew responding to that fire did end up needing some help after getting into a crash on Goldenrod Road near the 408. It does not appear anyone was seriously hurt in the
What a strange number. That is upon this bus right here. This is a psalm, probably the worst psalm of the Bible. Psalm 83. Probably the worst psalm over there. And beloved, this fire crew involved in crash, Goldenrod Road near Southwest State Road 408. Now, if you have 408 here, you know, you already know what that stands for. I'm gonna let you do your thing. The 12th tribe, of course, and Psalm 83 Gentiles. So Psalm 83 came in, and they came in against the children of the Most High and make them no more. Yep, they failed. So all praises to the Most High, man. Okay, these things happen over there in Orlando. And those things are not happening like ages ago. They're happening like yesterday, which is, you know, to the few hours past. Okay, all praises. Let us keep on moving.
For the home, another big headline locally. Look at these flames. This is out of Jupiter. Palm Beach County Fire Rescue investigating the cause of an early morning fire that destroyed a boat. Jesse Carbonari live outside the Square Grouper right in front of the marina where this all happened. I mean, just looking at those flames, unbelievable, Josie.
Yeah, hard to believe, Aaron. And you know what?
Okay, her name is Josie Carbonari. Huh. Josie. I believe Josie is a derivative of the word of the name Jesse. And is that what that is? And Carbon. It is, her name is really Carbon Air? Well, a black ebonic, but anyway.
Luckily, nobody was on board or injured when this all broke out. But as you mentioned, it's hard to believe it until you see it. These are the photos and images that we got earlier today when that fire broke out. This is what crew members and the owner of that 60-foot boat woke up to. Now, Palm Beach County Fire Rescue tells me it's a total loss. Earlier when the call came in just before 3 o'clock this morning, it was fully engulfed in flames. All of this happening at the Square Grouper boat ramp, which is an area with a lot of popular restaurants. And we watched multiple units respond, the battalion chief telling me because of the fuel on the boat, it took about 20 minutes to get it under control and another 2 hours or so to put out hot spots before wrapping up.
So again, if you've been following the Most High's work for at least a year now, you're seeing a massive amount of boats are catching on fire, whether they were at the marina, so to speak, or they were laying in the water or floating around, they just catching fire. All praises to Mosai.
Some boat owners who caught word moved their boats out of concern, but for one man I spoke with, he was docked right next to the boat that caught fire, and he says it was a close call.
The windows got shattered, paint got blistered. Lucky it didn't catch on fire. Real scary. I mean, that's like my livelihood. That's how I support my family.
See, the Mosa is terrifying them. Okay, this is that's how this man make money to feed his family, you know. Can you imagine his boat caught on fire or whoever, poor bastard, that his boat caught on fire? All praises, man.
Now, what exactly caused the fire is still unclear. We're told it's all under investigation.
All praises to the Most High, man. Fiery conflagration of the cities, okay? Their stuff are catching on fire all over, all right?
Flames have destroyed the St. Damiana Coptic Orthodox Church on the north side. The fire marshal is investigating after it caught fire overnight. It happened on Bernard Road, just off Main Street in the Pecan Park area. News 4 Jax reporter Janice Harris is live at the church where members have been praying. And Janice, what a loss.
It is definitely a loss, and to make matters worse, obviously it's raining, which is also going to damage the property that is already damaged. And you can see here the sign that says it is condemned. They're probably going to have to start over, but this is something that they are so heartbroken by today. fire destroyed this sacred place overnight. Jacksonville Fire Rescue arrived around 2 this morning. The fire was so intense, the building became unstable. The crews could not go inside.
How many times you see this? This is a church caught on fire. Well, but for some odd reason, they never say the word church. But anyway, how many times you seen this, brethren? That the fire that the firefighters came in to put out is so hot, it's so intense. They have to back off because this is not a regular fire. This fire is not being fueled by whatever fuel they have available over there. This is a holy fire. The Most High is burning down those whole houses.
The roof of the church collapsed. The priest for the church led a prayer earlier today with many of the people that attend.
Really?
And so
they didn't show the priest. Really? All right. Well, anyway.
Now it's in a rebuilding phase. They still have to have an insurance company to come here and figure out what they can do moving forward. And you also have the state fire marshal that is investigating this fire. But in the meantime, coming up tonight at 6, we're going to take a look back at some of the memories and what this building looked like before that fire destroyed it. Reporting live on the north side in Pecan Park, Janice Harris Channel.
So, yeah, this church, Northside Church. Okay, so this person, Heather Forfey, said, interesting, St. Paul Historic Church just burned down in Chicago, too. I didn't get that. I don't think I have that. Probably happened the same day. Let's see if we can pull that up. The Most High is destroying those whole houses, okay? So-called Christian. Wow. Okay. I probably have this there. Okay, St. Paul. Okay. All right, St. Paul. Wow. Oh, good Lord. Look at this. Wait a minute. Is that a Lutheran? Okay, let's watch this and then let's watch both of them. See what's going on here.
WGN's Kelly Davis is live in Beecher with our top story. Kelly, good evening.
I probably got this already, though.
Good evening, Taman and Jackie. The police chief just told me that his crew was actually responding to someone at the church that was completely unrelated to this fire. He says the EMS was there to treat a woman who was sick, but while they were there, they noticed the church was filling with smoke.
We saw smoke, black smoke, and I thought it was a fire from a house or something.
Todd Mayle was driving into town when he detoured down Church Street. There, he saw St. Paul's lit up in flames.
It's just an awful sight to see.
No, sir. This is a beautiful sight to see. The only awful thing to see is you freaking holding the phone vertically. Please do not shoot your videos in portrait. Hold your phone horizontally and then press record. Okay, you have to show the full glory of the Most High here. All praises, all right?
And shot this video. Flames ripped through the roof of St. Paul's Church.
Mm-hmm. I live just down the road, so I've seen it many times.
Zechariah, the prophet.
My grandparents are buried at the graveyard there, so it's really sad seeing the church.
Yeah, sorrow.
Like that.
Nearly a dozen different area fire departments responded. I'm told the fire may have started. Departments responded.
This number in the back of this church. What is that? Is a fire truck? Yeah. T12. Let me just hydrated the holy temple with the Holy Spirit. What do you think the T stand for? What do you think? I think the T stand for 12 or tribe 12. All praises. Yes, give the Most High glory, man. The Most High is grand, man. Beautiful stuff. Let us keep on moving.
I'm told the fire may have started in the steeple. It happened around 2 p.m. as the
Listen to what they said. They think the fire must have probably started in the steeple. You know, already right here, I'm seeing a face, like a demon face. Let me see if I can enlarge this and the people can see this. Okay, this is like the face right here. It look like a cat, like the rabbit, like face demon. This is the eyes right here. Another eyes right there. This is a nose, like a cat nose, you know, with his, with the lip, you know, slanting over there. And this is the other eye and eye. And then this look like the rabbit ear, or like the horn or the fear, you know, crazy things. All braces, crazy things. All right. Let us keep on moving.
The church was hosting its annual Oktoberfest. Fortunately, no one was hurt.
A church holding an Oktoberfest? Is that beer? Oh, anyway, so they say the fire must have started in the steeple. We know the steeples are like, are not like, they are antennas. They are antennas connected to the ley line, drawing the energy, and then send it to the demons out there. Okay.
This nearly one. A dozen different area fire departments responded.
Again, the word dozen again. Dozen and T12. All right.
I'm told the fire may have started in the steeple.
May have started in the steeple. All right.
Happened around 2 p.m. as the church was hosting its annual Oktoberfest. Fortunately, no one was hurt.
A bunch of people from the community came out to help clean up what we could. But there's a lot more to do.
The Lutheran Church has deep roots in Beecher. St. Paul's stood standing for more than 150 years.
Wow. Wow. All praises to the Most High.
It was even featured in the movie Road to Perdition about 20 years ago.
Well, it's been here for, what, since 1860?
Road to Perdition is a beautiful, beautiful movie. I recommend watching that movie. Okay, it's a beautiful movie. Road to Perdition. I believe it's in Hulu. Road to Perdition. Beautiful movie.
20 years ago.
Well, it's been here for, what, since 1865, so.
You know, 1865. What a weird date, 1865. I wonder.
It's an icon.
A lot of history there.
See the mark of the beast. My
grandparents used to go to church there all the time, so that was crazy.
The community is coming together to salvage anything they can with hopes of rebuilding.
There's other churches in the areas. I know everyone from there will help out, and we can just pray to God that they'll rebuild.
Okay, so what about that Jesus? You guys love Jesus. Okay, well, pray to God anyway. So, all right, thank you for whoever put this in that other comment. That's one church. Is it the same thing? Is it the same church? It looks like it's the same. Huh. Yes, St. Paul's. It is the same church. All right, then. We got that. You know? Okay, we got that. Okay. All right, then. We probably have it somewhere here. I don't watch those videos, okay? The Mosa is burning down the whole houses, okay? Christianity is the highest form of witchcraft. All your fallen angels, they are in your church. They are not in Hollywood. They are not in your music industry. What you are seeing the conspiracy theories are doing out there, that's not the true devils. The devil is a deceiver, is a seducer. He's not here to scare you. He's here to make you feel good, to make you feel right, and to feed and suck on your energy. All praises to the Most High. Yay. All right, let us go to the next video right there. Okay, this is St. Nicholas. So this is a big church, all right? This is a big church. This is St. Nicholas. This is in Ukraine. This is a very big church, but it caught in fire, okay? St. Nicholas caught in fire in Ukraine, September the 6th, 2021. Okay? All right? The Most High is burning their churches worldwide.
Reverend of the Celia Phelps Methodist Church here in Greensboro says he was excited to start welcoming members back for indoor services. But that excitement quickly diminished when he received an early morning phone call.
Oh, not the kind of call that you expect to get. Not at all.
Around 7 a.m., Reverend Ellis Carson received a call that the Celia Phelps United Methodist Church was on fire.
Well, on the way over here, I was hoping that it was just a minor fire that could have been put out and we'd be back in church.
So, and those are the Negroes, you know, with these with his shirt Fort Bragg, okay? General Bragg or Colonel Bragg. If you know what that guy did, you would have never put this shirt. Is that what that is? Fort Bragg in North Carolina, you would have never put this shirt on you. Those are the Negroes, brothers. Those are the two-thirds. Those are the whores, okay? Those are the people that are pissing off the Most High. Okay, they have to get back to church and or services. And the Most High tells you, don't go there. That's why he burned down your whole house. Beloved, we cannot be emotional about this. We cannot say, okay, well, he's black. Therefore, he's one of our people. He's a Hebrew man. Yay. Esau is a Hebrew man. Esau is a Hebrew Edomite. We are Hebrew Israelites. Esau is the brother of Jacob. Jacob went to his trouble, so now Esau is going to his trouble. Abraham has 8 sons. Okay, Joktan, Midian. You got 8 form of Hebrews out there. Not all of them are Israelites. This dude, I don't know him, but for lack of a better term, for the sake of this video, we say he's a two-third.
It's normal. But when I saw all of-
Okay, Fort Brace or Fort Bragg? It looks like it's a Fort Brace, okay? That would be better than Fort Bragg. That would be Fort Brace. All right.
Both fire trucks. And then when I walked up, I knew it was history.
Clifford Hurt.
Wait a minute. It's Fort Bragg. It's not Fort Brace. What the hell? Are the demons all messing with me here? Let me see. It is Fort Bragg. Let me see. Okay. It seems a little bit hard, you know. Let me see if there's a Fort Brace. North Carolina or Fort Bragg. Fort Brace, North Carolina. No. Because I don't want to say things to throw the people. Okay, it's Fort Bragg. That's what that is. No, there's no Fort Brace. It's Fort Bragg. Okay, Fort Bragg. Oops. Okay. Fort Bragg, North Carolina, is a military installation of the United States. Yes, I know that. Yeah, by, Bragg, General Bragg. General Bragg.
According to Wikipedia, Braxton Bragg was an American Army officer during the Second Seminole War and Mexican-American War and Confederate Army officer who served as a general in the Confederate Army during the American Civil War, serving in the Western Theater.
Okay, so this guy was a part of the Confederate which fought us. When this is Seminole, Mexican Army, those were our people, okay? So he was one of those Southern, good old Southern boy, General Bragg. And then you got this Negro right here wearing his shirt, wearing the shirt, Fort Bragg, North Carolina, okay? Anyway, man, so whatever, dude. You know, hey, you know, you do your thing.
But when I saw all those fire trucks, and then when I walked up, I knew it was history.
Clifford Hearn, one of the trustees of the church, says a fire appeared to have started in the sanctuary. Firefighters from the Pinecroft Sedgefield Fire Department responded around 3:20 in the morning.
Yeah, there's been a lot of grief, a lot of sadness.
Okay, Reverend Elise Carson. So those are the guys, brethren. This is my uncle here. This is my cousin here. This is my brother here. Those are the people you talk to them. They are hardcore Christians. Okay, this man here is a witch. This is a sorcerer. This man has the spirit of the fallen angels upon him.
This church has been here since 1920 in terms of the building.
What a weird day, 1920, you know, from 2020, 100 years, 101 years. Is that what that is? You've been making our people whores for over 100 years. You'll pay for that, man. You and your family and your ancestors.
1905 in terms of the worshiping congregation.
Throughout the years, the church has developed a rich history.
We've been through all sorts of things from Jim Crow and segregation to, you know.
Always put our people stuff in front. That's how they get most of our people. Oh, you've been to Jim Crow and segregation, but well, then you one of us. Yeah, whatever, man.
Civil rights and, up to current day.
We had just went back inside last Sunday, and we hadn't been inside in well over a year.
The Most High is keeping you outside, man. This should have been... Wait, hang on. Is that thing even recording right now? Oh, yes. Boy, we've been on there for 1 hour. Anyway, how could you not see this? How did you not even see the Holy Transmission here? The Most High keep you out of this damn church for a year. And then when you try to go back and it did burn it down, it should have told you something. Wait, something is wrong here, man. This could not be a coincidence. But hey, anyway, man, anything for the two-third, right?
Prior to just recently being let back into the church for indoor service, members of the church gathered outdoors and online due to the pandemic. But despite the challenges ahead, Reverend Carson says he has hope.
The church is the people to come together and worship. And, you know, buildings can be repaired. Everybody is safe, and that's what we're thankful for.
After examining the scene, the Guilford County Fire Marshal's Office says the fire was related to an unspecified malfunction in the air conditioning unit near the front entryway. Reverend Carlson says service will likely be held at a sister church for the time being. In Greens.
What? They have a sister church? Hang on, let me hear this again.
Fire was related to an unspecified malfunction in the air conditioning unit near the front entryway.
That's not what that is. It's the ley line. Put that thing in fire. Well, let me hear this again. What?
Reverend Carlson says service will likely be held at a sister church for the time being. In Greensboro, Colette Stein.
A sister church. Well, I thought he said that his sister have a church, but it's a sister church. But anyway, man. Brethren, there's nothing we can do. You know, the Most High is burning down those whole houses, and then those people are not getting this, and they've been out of the church for a year. Okay, they haven't been in there. So the Most High, you know, they opened everything and they were about to restart services. Then this happened. This should have told you something, man. I don't know, like, how did you people are not getting this? How did you not see this? Okay. Crazy. All praises. Let us keep moving, brothers, and see what the Most High is doing.
Yesterday morning at about 9:15, Kansas City, Missouri fire crews were dispatched here on a fire. When the first units got here, they saw smoke coming from the building, made entry into the building and found the front of the building and an area of stairs going down, fully involved in fire. As they started to egress that area, the stairway that led to the second, to the basement level of the church gave way. The fireman that was on it was not hurt. Thankfully, they were able to pull him out. And then within a few minutes of that, we're able to get the fire under control. There is pretty heavy fire damage to the front of that church. As you can see, it's not a very big structure. But there is pretty heavy fire damage in there. The actual sanctuary of the church was not impinged by fire. The fire didn't make it in there, but there is smoke and water damage in there. My understanding and talking to some of the trustees of the church is they have every intention of doing whatever needs to be done restoratively to continue to use the church, clean it up, those types of things, rebuild what needs to be rebuilt. Kansas City Fire, when they arrived, one of the two front doors was standing open. Based on that, they contacted Kansas City Bomb and Arson and ATF.
Oh boy.
ATF
oh
has a congressional boy. Mandate to investigate fires at houses of worship. And then, as you all know, we investigate fires anytime we're requested by state or local authorities. So in this case, our fire investigators have been working with detectives from Bomb and Arson and the investigative unit from the Kansas City Fire Department yesterday and then all day today. They've determined that this was a set fire.
Of course.
That's a federal crime. Setting a fire in a house of worship is a federal crime. ATF will take the lead on that investigation and continue to work it in conjunction with the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department Bomb and Arson Unit.
Mm-hmm.
So anybody that has any information, anybody that was in this area,
don't call us. Keep it to yourself. Whoever did this did a good job for the Most High. Okay, so what you are seeing here, beloved, what you are witnessing here, the Heavenly Father is setting up people out there. They have demons out there that's going, and then they are, you know, giving those people hell. Okay, they are giving those people a lot of hell. And what's happening right now? It's the Most High is in the midst. And a lot of churches, a lot of whorehouses are being burned down. All praises to the Most High.
And today, a church is coming together after someone tried to set it on fire earlier this week. Julie Palazzo is live in Germantown this morning with more on how they are responding. Julie, can you hear me? What can you tell us?
Okay, so you can see the Negro over there praying with them, you know, and stuff like that. You know, that's what the Negro is doing, man. That's what the Negro is doing. All right. So, you know, this is exactly what that is, brothers. Okay. So we cannot feel sorry for those people, man. Okay. We cannot feel sorry for those people. Okay. That's why the Most High, you know, he's doing those things. And we are seeing this. Something happened to this brother walking down the street. We cannot be emotional about this. All right. All praises to the Most High. Let this keep on playing.
Yeah, Nikhil, good morning. Just stepped out of frame here just so you can see what we're seeing here. The church's leadership team usually gathers. This is the Axis Church in Germantown around this time, usually inside of the church. But because of that Molotov cocktail being thrown in and the damage, they decided to move their usual prayer service around the corner, just a couple of blocks away in a park here in Germantown. Now, this time they invited the community. It appears that a couple community members are here along with some members of the leadership team. At first, there were only a couple of people, but just over the last couple of minutes, quite a few people have walked over here. But let's give you a recap of the investigation.
Someone threw a Molotov cocktail
through the church's front window late Monday night, but fire crews in the church didn't discover the fire until after 1 o'clock Tuesday morning. The bottle caused significant smoke damage throughout the facility, especially in the front lobby. Mm-hmm. And I spoke with the church's director of community engagement a short time ago, Lindsay Hamilton. She said crews have made quick progress and they are hoping to have the sanctuary open for service this Sunday. She also talked about outreach from the community that's been overwhelming for them and they are very grateful. We were just kind of like, are you good? Are you okay? And we were just like, yeah, like, gonna work through it. It's just a building. It's all replaceable. So nobody's hurt, and that's what we're thankful for.
All right. So, yeah. All right. That one Negro always there.
News 2 reached out to the Nashville Fire Department and the ATF, both agencies working on this investigation. They said that there are no significant updates to share at this time, but the church is still encouraging anyone with information to come forward. Reporting live in Germantown, Julia Palazzo, News 2.
All praises to the Most High, man. All praises. So, as you can see, brothers, those things are not happening ages ago, okay? This happened September 15, 2020, okay? All right, the Most High is burning down the whole houses, even though they want to reopen and worship and do hold on there, all praises.
A burned flag and a man with his pants around his ankles. That is what officers say they found inside a church on Maryville Pike. So this happened Tuesday morning at Mount Olive Baptist Church. Now the man arrested, Dakota Snook, is accused of arson at a place of worship. According to court documents, Snook told officers he did not like the flag because he is not a Christian. Snook is also charged with burglary and vandalism. Officers say they found inside a church on Maryville.
Yo, listen to Dakota, man. Okay, he could be, the name of this dude is Dakota. He could be one of our people. You know, it could be one of our people. So, you know, his name is Dakota. So, you know, Lakota, the Dakota, you know, the Dakota tribe. You know, this guy, you know, listen to what he said, according to the people.
Pike. So this happened Tuesday morning at Mount Olive Baptist Church. Now the man arrested, Dakota Snook, is accused of arson at a place of worship. According to court documents, Snook told officers he did not like the flag because he is not a Christian.
So Dakota tell them he does not like the look at Dakota face, man. This dude, first of all, he looked like a demon. He's a typical Christian. he has the look of the typical patriot Christian with this horn. He got little horn over there, a horn over there, and another horn right here. He has the typical look of the Christian brothers, okay? And then all of a sudden, this guy come over there, and then he told you straight up that, you know, he's not a Christian. He doesn't like this. You know, all praises to the Most High. It could be one of our people, man. Good job, Dakota Snook. You know, he did a good job here. All praises to the Most High. I mean, this is beautiful, all right?
Snook is also charged with burglary and vandalism.
All praises. All praises, man. All right? Crazy things. All right. Let me pause this at 1:56. I don't know what time. I'm going to keep coming. I'm going to be back. So, I'm back at 2:42 a.m. Boy, all right, let us move in. Let us move in. To you, it's instant. To me, it's been an hour. All right.
In St. George, investigators are looking into three fires at LDS churches. The first fire happened at the church on 1295 South and 30th East at around 4 this morning. The second one happened at the church on River Road and Rustic Drive.
So the Church of Latter-day Saint, LDS, is catching hell. You people are catching hell over there in Utah, Yehuda, Judah, Zaza.
The third happened at the church on 1762 South and River Road. Officers say they chased a man from the scene of the last fire onto I-15. They arrested him after they disabled the minivan that he was in. Crews say the church on 30th East did not have a fire suppression system, so damage there is extensive. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints reacted to the fires with a statement which reads, quote, "We are saddened by the intentional damage that has occurred at three of our meeting houses in St. George. Our church buildings are places of worship and community gathering where all are welcome."
No, that's not what that is. Your church is not a place of community gathering or something. It's a place of whoredom. You guys come over there and do all sort of witchcraft, Christianity, Mormonism or Catholicism, ain't all religions are from Satan. Your fallen angels are not in Hollywood, nor they are in the music industry. They are in the churches. Your pastors, they have the spirit upon them. All praises.
We're fully cooperating with authorities as they conduct their investigation, and inquiries about these incidents should be directed to them.
All praises. See, the Most High is burning down those whole houses.
A former parishioner is in custody tonight on suspicion of intentionally setting a South Bay church on fire. Good evening. I'm Steve Atkinson.
And I'm Lindsay Pena. Surveillance cameras caught that man starting the fire overnight. Now, investigators are trying to figure out a motive.
I'm gonna put on an iron shirt, chase the devil out the earth. Let me drink some water, man. Yeah. The Most High is always in the mist. And the Most High is telling you that he's doing this over there. So in this fire truck again, another fire truck, since we are dealing with fire, plague number 2, and there is the number 12 in there. So we give the Most our praises and glory. That's how you give the Father glory. He's over there and he's speaking to his children.
Services at Church of Christ Iglesia Ni Cristo in National City had to be relocated Thursday morning after an overnight fire left part of the building seriously damaged. That incident was caught on surveillance video, video that helped police make an arrest quickly. Investigators say 37-year-old Ace Thomas Rancudo was taken into custody Thursday, suspected of arson. National City Police say Rancudo was a former parishioner of the church. Detectives say the video shows the suspect pouring a flammable liquid on the doors and throwing a lit cigarette onto the spot. After that failed to ignite it, police say the person walked over and lit it by hand before taking off in a gray pickup truck. It was that truck that led officers to Rancudo. As for the fire, first responders say officers on patrol kept it from spreading to the rest of the building.
Their quick action of calling it in and getting emergency services rolling, along with that initial extinguishment, for sure prevented it from migrating from where it is today into the interior portion of the church.
At this point, investigators haven't released any information about the motive for the crime. Rancudo was booked into the jail on felony arson charges.
Okay, no motive? That guy was a former parishioner over there, you know. You know, probably he was coming with the truth. They kick him out, you know. Let's look at this word parishioner, you know. Excuse me. What is a parishioner?
Here's the definition of parishioner. an inhabitant of a parish, especially one who belongs to or attends a particular church.
Okay, so, okay, what does that mean to be a parishioner? A person who goes to a particular local church, a person who belongs to a parish. See the full definition for a parishioner. So this guy, they could have used another better name. It could have been an ex-churcher, a churchgoer, an ex-fellow that used to go to a Judas church. Okay, so what is another word for a parishioner? A layman, okay, a believer. He was a member, or an ex-member, okay? He was well, they put the ley line here, a layman, which is the proper name for guys that work in electricity power company. So this guy, he was a former member, a parishioner. Okay, if I'm getting that right, if I'm not, brothers, please correct me in the comment board. That's how that is. That's how we do it here. I don't always know stuff, brothers. Things escape me, and then certain things are not... they are not sitting too well in my head, you know, especially when it's like 2:48 a.m. for, you know, when I'm doing this video. So certain things I said, they are wrong. Please correct me with kindness, please. Yes, an ex-member, most likely that guy find out that you people were leading him straight to hell. And then he was pissed off and burned down your freaking whole house. May the Most High protect this dude and make him one of those master demon in hell and whip you guys when you get there. All praise.
A church in Brownsville getting help from the community as they clean up after their building was vandalized.
Channel 5's Stephanie Rosales is live outside that church with a look at how their efforts are going. Stephanie.
As you can see behind me now, there's nothing but a clean white wall and clean bricks. But this past weekend, this side of the building was covered in graffiti, including some prominent symbols of hate. Saturday morning, right before his 9 a.m. service, Pastor Marlon Wallace says he was alerted about some property damage on the side of the building. Unfortunately, he says he's seen this before, even saying there have been attempts to break into the church in the past.
Just think that happens but once in a while. But this time it was, you know, some words like God doesn't exist and we hate you and some swastik symbols there.
Church members are also sharing their concerns.
I despise when people blur this thing as if they never see a swastika, if I'm saying this right. Okay, just like, yo, why are you doing this? Brethren, I'm gonna tell you the truth. If I own a church, thank God I don't. If I ever had a church, I would have never get out of this church. I would have sleep in there. You know, plus I wouldn't, you know, pay no rent, and I don't pay those taxes, 501c3, swagger jacking people. I'll do all sort of thing in this church. And I would have all kind of camera because I know what I'm doing out there is wrong and people gonna come after me. So I will go out there and put camera and all that stuff, but those people don't because they got mention. You know, why would you stay in the church when you got a freaking mention?
Who has been coming to the church for 3 years says what he saw was hurtful.
Ever since my family's been coming here, never, everybody's really friendly here. No, never had we had a.
So those are the people, okay? when you see those guys are getting shot in parking lot, and something they shot in the highway, there's nothing you can do. There's nothing you can say because they make the choice. At this time right now, if you choose to be in a Christian church or whatever church or any religions, it's on you.
Problem with people hate us.
Pastor Wallace says this was worse than past examples of graffiti that have been left on the church.
All praises, okay, all praises to the Most High. You see this, beloved, again, we still in plague number 2, fiery conflagration of the city. The Most High is burning down their whole houses. We got many videos, plenty videos, brothers, our churches burning down and other things that are going on, okay? They are all in the playlist, okay?
And new tonight, the hunt is now on for 3 people after a St. Louis Catholic Church in Louisville was vandalized. Parishioners found that graffiti when they arrived at Mass yesterday. The vandals spray painted a door with "My Body, My Choice," as well as other messages on signs. A surveillance camera recorded 3 people at the church at about 1:30 Sunday morning. Connor. And new tonight, the hunt is now on for three people after a St. Louis Catholic church in Louisville was vandalized. Parishioners found that graffiti when they arrived at Mass yesterday. The vandals spray-painted a door with "My Body, My Choice," as well as other messages on signs.
So you got those church, those Catholic church, they got like millions of dollars. Look at the quality of the video that they have and stuff. People, man, come on, man. All praise is the Most High, man.
This is the highlight of Lucy Santiago and
let me enlarge this so the people can do what they do best here when they see the Most High wrath. All praises, man. Yes. Woo. All praises. Saint Michael's vandalized. All praises to the Most High. Another Michael.
And Lillian Soto's day, praying in front of their parish, St. Michael's, in Flushing. They usually leave happy. Today, that wasn't the case.
I think we did this before. Is it Flushing, Brooklyn? Let me see when this was. So, August 6th, 18. I think we did something like that. Yeah, that's the update. It seems that. I'm not quite sure.
In the early morning hours Tuesday, a man hopped this short fence in front of the church and pushed over the statue of Saint Bernadette, breaking her arm.
They have no business trying to destroy the statue because they're the ones who support us, you know, the saints in heaven.
You heard that? Those the saints in heavens, they are the one who support us. Those people are true believers, man, true parishioners, true members. So now when you see the water come and then those people grave or digged out, their coffin came out, you cannot say, brothers, oh, well, you know, she's a little lady, she's like an old little lady. No, that's a experience hall right there. For people to just sit like that and sit like this and say things like this in this time right now. The Most High is bringing the wrath. You are pissing off the Most High. You guys think you are doing a good thing? Okay.
Saints in heaven.
That's camera. That's.
Well, the saints are here. We are the saints, not you people.
The vandal was caught on camera. The police were called to investigate, and tape was put up. A process Father Vincentius Doe shuddered to think he'd ever be involved in.
We never thought about this thing when we build these churches. You know, everything was in the open, but.
So those are the Korean fellows. I don't know. Some kind of Moabite Episcopal. I don't know.
Now we have to protect ourselves.
Of course, if you know the name of those Korean church, they got a specific name which escaped my mind. Because frankly, I don't really pay attention to things like that. But you can put it in the comment board or in the live chart.
St. Michael's joins a long list of churches and schools across the Diocese of Brooklyn that have been vandalized this year.
Of course.
At this spot, St. Bernadette is kneeling in front of the Blessed Mother. Surrounding them, a white flag for every parishioner lost to COVID-19.
Oh, well, okay, that's beautiful. That's for once you scumbag did something beautiful.
St. Bernadette is the patron saint of those who are ridiculed for their faith, but the parish doesn't think this is an attack, but a problem that goes much deeper within the Flushing community.
I tend to think that these people are suffering from some kind of mental issues. That's why I ask my parishioners to pray for them. And
that's not what that is. They are the stuff that, well, they are an agent that the Most High sent out there to go against you and your church. That's what that is, sire. That's what that is.
Hopefully they get some help because I think they do need help.
Now St. Michael's is left to literally pick up the pieces. Fences,
you know? Oh, you see. She's
Father Doe hopes his parishioners will chip in to fix the statue.
Wait a minute. I didn't see that. We haven't done that yet. That's new. That's new. I haven't done that. There's another one that got messed up. We haven't done this. It's that's new. So chip in. All right. Swagger jacking. Still now you guys don't have enough money to do this. But anyway, man.
But he says the pain costs more than the repairs. In Flushing, Jessica Easthope, Currents News.
The pain costs more than the repairs. the pain costs more than the repair. All praises the Most High, man. The Most High is destroying you people and your whole houses.
The gun violence continued this afternoon in West Oak Lane. That's where a 28-year-old woman was just shot and killed on the 6900 block of North Broad. Police tell...
So a 28-year-old woman, let me see this car right there. There's a truck, and it's like a police car. Yeah, it has like number 3522 in there. I wouldn't add that up because I'm not that smart. I don't know if the Most High is here. Is he in the mist? Is he doing this? Is he over there? Again, this is plague number nine. Boy, I'm getting tired. 2:58. Oh, it's going to be 3 a.m. I got a doctor appointment to bring my mom at 8 a.m. Okay, but anyway, execution by the sword, okay? So, yeah, that's what that is, man. Okay, execution by the sword right here.
North Broad. Police tell us she was shot once in the head and they arrested a male gunman.
Yeah, all praises. Let us move into the next bridge.
Leaves at least four people dead and 10 others injured. I'm Jason Martinez.
I'm Shayna Humphreys. The blame is going around. Fingers are being pointed among city officials this evening. Our Jeff Cole has more from a memorial for one of the shooting victims. Jeff.
Yeah, this is Bronwyn Chu. The memorial behind me is for a 26-year-old shot in a drive-by shooting yesterday afternoon. It has been a violent period in the city of Philadelphia. Today, though, Mayor Jim Kenney shot back at city councilwoman Cindy Bass, who harshly criticized him yesterday. A memorial grows on Chu Avenue, just off Broad, for Stephen Jones, the 26-year-old slain Monday by a drive-by shooter.
He was a father of three. Yes, he was. So we have three children we have to worry about right now.
The brazen attack wounded five in a shooting around the corner from the busy Olney Transportation Center, the scene of another mass shooting just months ago.
They don't feel safe.
The attack angered District Council member Cindy Bass, who turned her ire on the mayor.
Where is our mayor? We need...
Now, why is that? Why is they are turning on each other right now? Why they are blaming each other? Let me tell you why. Well, let us tell you why. Let us, the Most High, speak through the bullhorn, his microphone, his speaker. This is why. Because they are not in control. One. Two, because the angels are reporting back. Because we give them a spirit of confusion, turn them against each other, have them taking each other out. You see, when those people were in the blessing, they were in control. They used to set things up like that and then have the media blast it. Now they're going at each other's throat.
We need help. We need leadership. We need an ear in this neighborhood and this community, and we need it now.
Kenny says Bass is a finger pointer who only had to call.
Was not aware of the shooting, and she didn't call me on the phone. She has my phone number, so I'm surprised why she wouldn't call me.
Kenny says he was meeting with a federal official trying to land tens of millions of dollars to combat homelessness.
Nah. You guys always, ever since you guys push our people out of land and then you keep, oh, homeless is a problem. Let me tell you this, man. There's no such thing as a homeless problem in America, nor around the world. This world doesn't have a homeless problem. This world have a greedy problem. This will have a Gentiles problem, a freaking heathen problem. This will have a Satan problem. There are enough houses around this world for people to live free without paying a penny. But you scumbag raise the price. You make all the rules. You do all sort of things. And then right now, oh, we need tens more million to pack it off, you know, to fill up our pocket. And then, you know, swagger jacking, all that stuff. And there's no homeless crisis. You guys... This thing can be resolved, well, with the Most High's wrath anyway.
Gun violence in the city is raging, with 386 killings outpacing last year's homicides. Will you change policy in any way? Is there something you need to do immediately?
Well, first of all, Philadelphia police, SEPTA police, and school police were a block or less away when this happened.
Police say the department's...
Yes. Yes, this is beautiful, brothers. You see, they are turning on each other. Okay, the city commissioner, I don't know what that woman was. Whatever that woman was, turned on the mayor, and the mayor turned on the police. Well, first of all, the police were like a few blacks. They should have been seeing this and stuff like that. See, brothers, the two-thirds, they are expendable. The Mosai is using them, okay? They are expendable. If those people can even contain this little, well, plague that they have here, this little chaos, how the F they're going to bring Jacob's trouble, man? You people can do nothing, man. Scumbags out there, you know, taking the glory from the Most High and act like you're all that. You ain't all that, man. You ain't that smart, man.
Commanders rushed to the scene Monday, but Commissioner Danielle Outlaw was not among them.
Should maybe she have been there? She was not there. Should she have been there in your view?
I don't know what else she was doing. Maybe she was doing something that she couldn't get out of.
Police say Outlaw was at a meeting and sent her top deputies who kept her informed.
We need our mayor to engage, act like you care.
Councilmember said she could not speak on camera Tuesday. Back on Chew, the victim's name is posted in silver on a wall while dark balloons sway in the breeze amid calls for justice.
Justice would also include knowing who killed him, correct?
That is the justice. We want that. We need that. We desire that.
For some reason, she seems very familiar. I don't know. Do I know this sister from somewhere? Not quite sure. She seems very familiar to me. I don't know why, but
Mayor Kenney says he certainly does care. Now, Fox 29 asked the city council today, with violence raging, why did it take its summer break? A spokesperson for the city council said it's been involved in gun buybacks. It's gone to communities where gun violence is.
Scumbag stuff. Gun buyback. None of those things will work. You guys have to come out there and admit it. The 400 is up, pay up, get the hell off of Orleans.
Down and says it has never stopped working on this crisis. Live up here in North Philly in Fern Rock, Jeff Cole.
Yeah, whatever, man. All praises. This is plague number 9, execution by the sword. And let us keep on moving, beloved.
And released, but at this point police say they don't know if what happened in the person that was found in the freezer was actually a retired LA County Sheriff's detective and sergeant, and her daughter has been questioned and released, but at this point police say they don't know if what happened in that house was criminal or just odd. It's a house so strange, Riverside police officers couldn't find the front door. But it's what they discovered inside that sparked an investigation. The frozen body of an 87-year-old retired LA County Sheriff's Sergeant.
Oh boy.
Now detectives want to know if her death was natural or a crime.
We're still waiting for the autopsy report. Once we get those reports, we'll know exactly in which direction this...
this dude's name is Javier Cabrera. Okay. All right, shout out to the sister anyway.
This investigation is going to go.
Riverside police say Miriam Travis lived in the home with her 64-year-old daughter, but it was her other...
What? He's 87. The daughter is 64-year-old. Okay, all right then. Whoops. She was collecting them checks. Okay, somebody say something here. 64-year-old daughter still living with your father? All right. Okay, I have a daughter too. Okay, then, what's going on here?
Other daughter who lives out of state, who grew worried after not hearing from mom in 2 months.
Okay,
that's why she asked police lived in the home with her 64-year-old daughter. But it was her other daughter who lives out of state, who grew worried after not hearing from mom in 2 months. That's why she asked police to do a welfare check on Sunday morning on the 66
Mission Grove. Okay.
600 block of New Ridge Drive.
6600 black, 6600 blacks, do your thing.
Right. Police say her sister was home, but mom was not.
You noticed some inconsistencies with their story as to what mom's whereabouts.
Okay, the mom's, what is it? The guy name is Mom's? I'm getting very confused here. Is that what that is? The fellow name is Mom's. Hang on.
A welfare check on Sunday morning on the 6600 block of New Ridge Drive. Police say her sister was home, but mom was not.
You noticed some inconsistencies with her story as to what mom's whereabouts. They detained the daughter and ultimately went inside the residence, and they located the mother deceased inside a freezer in the garage of the residence.
Okay, the mother Wait a minute. This is very confusing to me. I thought the father, what's going on here? I'm very tired. I'm not getting this straight. What? Was it let me watch this in the beginning, man. I'm getting very confused here. Let me watch this. I don't want to make mistake here.
Yes, the person that was found in the freezer was actually a retired LA County Sheriff's detective and sergeant. And her daughter has been questioned and released. But at this point, police say they don't know if what happened in that house was criminal or just odd. It's a house so strange, Riverside police officers couldn't find the front door.
Okay.
But it's what they discovered inside that sparked an investigation.
Okay, woman finding freezer work for LA. Okay, that was a woman. I don't know why I say a man. I don't know what's going on with me. All right, let's see.
The frozen body of an 87-year-old retired LA County Sheriff's Sergeant. Now detectives want to know if her death was natural or a crime.
Okay. We're still waiting for the autopsy report. Once we get those reports, we'll know exactly in which direction this investigation is going to go.
Riverside police say Miriam Travis lived in the home with her 64-year-old daughter, but it was her other daughter, who lives out of state, who grew worried after not hearing from mom in 2 months.
Okay, all right. I was so confused. It turned out they were all females. Oh, boy. Oh boy, yeah, 3 a.m. So, okay, all right, that's what happened. There were women, a daughter. I'm like, what? She living with a 64, and then the father is 87? Wow, that's a good father. But no, they were women. She was living with her mother. My apology. Sometimes things like that happen.
That's why she asked police to do a welfare check on Sunday morning on the 6600 block of New Ridge Drive. Police say her sister was home, but mom was not.
We noticed some inconsistencies with her story as to what mom's whereabouts. They detained the daughter and ultimately went inside the residence, and they located the mother deceased inside a freezer in the garage of the residence.
Oh boy.
So far, there has been no arrest, and the daughter wasn't home when we went by the house. Travis worked for LA County for 27 years.
Okay, Travis. Is it the last name? Or that's her first name? Travis is usually a man name. Why are they all doing this? Why can't they use the first name like Samantha Travis or Vanessa or some Tanisha? Why do they use Travis? So what the hell is going on? You see, this is why I keep getting confused here, man.
And had even been a detective in the elite homicide bureau.
Sheriff
Alex Villanueva said in a statement, "Our hearts are broken by this news, and the entire LASD family mourns her loss."
Mourns her loss. Like which one? Wouldn't mourn her loss, or wouldn't be just straight to mourn her death, or mourn her past, or mourn her transition, mourn her loss? I'm not doing too well now. What's going on here?
In addition to the autopsy reports, detectives are also waiting on financial records to see if there was a pension or perhaps social security checks that were misused.
All right. Okay. So
24-hour.
There you go. Well, that's what happened. So those people are very professional when they were reporting that news. I got so confused. Well, we don't know what happened. We'll say execution, but it could be by the sword, not by the sword. Seems not. It's not by the sword. But hey, people, those police officers. You don't know what that woman was 87 years old. You don't know what she did when she was in that department to all people. Well, at least justice is served by the hand of their own. Well, I'm not gonna say the daughter, but yeah. 's called scoping them out. So yeah, the two-thirds don't play this issue. Anytime you go any place, you see a bunch of Negroes just chill there. You know, what's up with you? A bunch of Negroes standing there up to no good. If they're standing in front of a store, go to another one. Okay, because they up to no good. They have nothing to do. They just sit there and then empty vessels. Then they are waiting for some demon to jump on them. So yeah, that's what that is, man. You know, the two-thirds out there, you know, they need like one person. They need to shoot one person, this woman, and they need one guy, and they just shoot every single person in there. You know, they don't care. Okay, all praises to the Most High, man. The sword is heavy. Shocking. Philadelphia police release video of deadly drive-by shooting. Gunmen still being sought. Yeah, man, something's going on in Philly, man. Plague number 9, execution by the sword. The sword is heavy in the land, man.
More gun violence in broad daylight. Police tell us a 15-year-old was shot at 22nd and Master in North Philadelphia. He was hit in the shin. Police rushed the teenager to Temple University Hospital, where he is in stable condition. So far, no one has been arrested.
All praises.
Two of the four suspects in the beating death outside Pat Steaks in South Philadelphia, 32-year-old Omar Arce and 33-year-old Jose Alberto Flores Huerta, are in custody. Both are facing numerous charges, including murder and attempted murder, following the beating death of Isidro Cortez last week outside the iconic cheesesteak shop. The father of Cortez and a friend were also hurt in the attack. Police are still searching for two other men.
I just love this story, man. It's just like, yo, those guys just have a great time doing some soccer, enjoying the blessing. And then some dude was talking trash, and then they just take a trash lead and they hit the fellow in the head with all their might. They kill him.
Thank you, Ashley. It is 4:32. Breaking news right now. Neighbors wake up to gunshots overnight at the Peaks at MLK Apartments. That's in Northwest Atlanta. Police say three people were shot. We're told shooting happened after a woman's ex-boyfriend confronted her current boyfriend. All three shot in the leg and taken to the hospital. We're working to see if any charges are going to be filed.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. All praises, man. Sword is heavy. Two-thirds unrepented scum. Yep.
Kingwood.
A 14-year-old is dead after a shooting. The Montgomery County Sheriff's Department says a woman spotted the boy's body on North King Mills Lane and Kings Mill Park. Brandon Walker is live to tell us the latest information from the scene. Brandon?
Hey, good morning to you, Owen. Very few details on this one, but we can tell you that investigators from the Montgomery...
Well, it feels like I did this before, okay? I don't know, but I'm going to let this play. But there are so many of them feel like I have done this.
County Sheriff's Office, they remain centered on that walking trail you see there behind me. It leads down to the pond. That's the center of this investigation. They remain here on scene working to piece this one together. We're told a woman last night at around 8:20 heard gunshots, and then she saw a group of men running here from the area.
She continued her walk and she came upon an unresponsive black male lying on the sidewalk who suffered from multiple gunshot wounds.
Yeah, as I mentioned, that was around 8:20 last night at the 25,000 block of North Kings Mill Lane, according to the Montgomery County Sheriff's Office. Beyond that, investigators have not released much about what they think are the circumstances surrounding this young man's apparent killing. Again, we do know that he was 14 years old, but we don't know anything about a suspect or where that search is right now.
All praises to the Most High. There was an incident that happened close to where we at. There's a 14-year-old girl. She was playing with a bunch of 13 and 12-year-old boy. And doing the playground, the play, donkey play. They were playing football. And she slipped and she fell, I believe. And the boys were laughing and stuff like that. And she took pepper spray and she pepper sprayed them. She pepper sprayed all of them. And then she ran home. So police was called. They brought her to her house. They brought the police to her house and then they brought her back. And they were interviewing her. She was laughing as if it was funny. Okay? And we leave it at that. And that's why you see a 14-year-old shot to death. You don't know what this 14-year-old did, okay? And they will do things like this and they think it's funny because they saw it on social media where people will pepper spray people and then they are laughing and they think this is cool. So we leave it at that. And when you see things like that happen, you're like, yo, what happened? What this? We don't know why did this kid done and stuff. And then, hey, you curse somebody and then somebody curse you out. All praises to the Most High. This is plague number 9, execution by the sword.
Helicopter carrying 3 people crashed in Jasper County, killing all 3. Now, within the past hour, the FAA released the names of the 3 victims. They are pilot Alistair Pereira, age 42, pilot Charles Ogolvy, age 46, and Carson McElhenney, age 40. Authorities have not released where they're from. Earlier today, law enforcement held a news conference at a Jasper County church. Molly Jett was there as investigators worked to figure out what caused the crash.
The helicopter crashed about 2 miles from here in the Oconee National Forest. Cell phones and an emergency locator transmitter helped searchers locate the helicopter on Thursday. Jasper County Sheriff Donnie Pope said rain and mud made the search for the helicopter difficult.
There was very little fire associated with the crash, so we didn't have smoke to be able to find the location. And then the terrain was extremely difficult.
The FAA says the helicopter left Thompsonville in South Georgia Wednesday and was headed northwest when it started to have trouble.
During that flight towards the accident scene, there were low clouds and visibility and rain showers in the area at the time.
No. At Friday's news conference, Aaron McCarter with the National Transportation Safety Board called it a high-energy crash and said the copter crashed about 125 feet through the trees before stopping.
So indicating that there was some forward velocity and some speed associated with the accident.
The helicopter was owned by a Nashville company called Monarch Helicopters. They give helicopter tours. The helicopter made no stops and authorities still don't know where they were headed or why they were flying.
I can't actually say that this helicopter was being operated by that tour company in Nashville. Sometimes it's much more complicated than that. There's letters of agreement. It could be wet lease back. So that's something they're going to have to determine a little bit later time.
Friday, recovery crews brought in a special piece of equipment called a Godzilla to help remove the copter. Pope said it was emotionally a difficult search.
A Godzilla, okay. What is the proper name for Godzilla in the Bible? We drink a little, well, in our books, drink a little water here. All breezes. The Leviathan. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There were members of that family that were here directly talking to us like I'm talking to y'all. And it becomes very personal.
The helicopter will be examined in Atlanta by NTSB, the Robinson Helicopter Company, which built it, and the Rolls-Royce Company, which produced the engine.
This is not what that is. You people still don't understand. This thing crashed 2 miles away from this freaking church. This church has a steeple in it. It's sending energy. The ley line took those people out. all three of them or no more, because it's the ley line that has nothing to do with the engine and stuff. You guys keep seeing this thing happening so much now.
In Jasper County, Molly Jett, 13W MAZ News.
Oh, crap. All right. Well, all praises to the Most High, man. Let us keep on moving. All right, so deported Haitian migrants arrive in Port-au-Prince. So these dudes say what they did is illegal. We spend a lot of money in this Haitian to come over there, and then they send us back. Okay, so that's what happened. And let us watch, and I'll tell you what's going on here.
I tried three times. The first time I lost my money and I came back here. The second time I also lost my money because immigration caught me. The third time I was able to enter directly, but I got deported, but I was brought back to my country.
I want to look for a better life because of my children.
Okay, she's speaking Spanish, all right?
Now I sit here and think about what opportunities my country has for me. If my country can offer me a new opportunity, I'll stay here. But if I don't get any opportunities, I'll be forced to go to another country.
All right, so it's pretty much done. If the so-called the United States government, whether they were the Democrats or the Republican or any of them, wanted those people to get there, they would have, they, if they did not want them to get there, you won't even hear anything about it. Last time I checked the video on Fox News, it has a million views. The Mossad is bringing these peculiar people, these specific people in the news almost all the time. Trump, ever since Trump was there, say this Haitian country, why did you bring in those people over there? They have a specific hatred for the so-called Haitian, and there is a reason. You see, what you're calling Haitian, that's not what they are. They are a specific tribe. Okay, most of them, if not all of them, will sell out. They sold out. Those were the people that were supposed to be holding the book, leading the people to the Most High, doing the ceremony, the closest to the Most High. They were, nope, they sold out. That is why the Most High purified them. Okay, the Most High passed them through the holy furnace and purified the sons of Aaron. It purified them, the priest, he did. And I've seen this. It took me a while, though. I didn't know what was going on, but he did. The whole thing, brothers, was used as two things. You see, this isn't the first time things like that happened. It happened every single week. Sometimes they got like 20, 40, 50,000 of them. Okay, they never make the news. This particularly make the news. Why? Because they wanted to get your attention. They wanted to bring you in a low vibration. Why? Because the 2 days when that thing was happening, we had the full moon. Okay? They know the Most High is sending massive amount of cosmic energy. Why did you think this thing happened in like the 19th? Why did you think the volcano happened on the same day? If we were distracted, we wouldn't know. We wouldn't see, we wouldn't get that holy transmission. Brothers, let me tell you something. Our people are resilient. We are literally indestructible. You cannot destroy us. Yes, they will use this story and show you, oh man, all those things are happening. You should feel sad. You should feel worried. You should feel this and stuff. And when you do things like that, and then you lower your shield, you lower your frequency, then you're in trouble. Whatever the Most High sent out there, you will not receive it. One of the reasons why we did not focus on this, we acknowledge this, but we did not discuss it because of this. Now you see all the stuff that the Most High is sending. Be worried, bro. Worry not. Our people are fine. Our people are fine. Everybody that you see here are healthy. There's nothing wrong with them. It's just certain things those people are doing down there, you know, in the island. So they are trying to move a group of people out of it. But they cannot move them out of it. Okay? The Most High say enough. Our people don't have to go all over the world trying to work for others. He said the world is ours now. Very soon, brothers, you will see the wrath of the Most High moving certain people off of our land. And they can't get what's down there in Haiti. They've been trying for over 400 years, but they can't. It's not for them to get. It's not anointed unto them to get it. That's why they were using the whole thing as like a distraction to take you away from the holy transmission that the Father said the palm tree is already put down and the grand entrance is here. It will happen. All praises to the Most High.
An angry customer taking out his frustrations on a waitress at a restaurant in North Miami. The victim, who's a young mother, tells Local 10 News that she was beaten and she has quit her job out of fear. She spoke exclusively to Local 10's Rosh Lowe. He's live with the disturbing details. Rosh.
Well, this guy ordered a punch, and we're not talking about fruit punch. We're talking about a wallop several times to the head of a waitress who was on the ground being beaten. You'll see part of what she went through on surveillance video, and she's so afraid she lost her job. So this one will make your stomach turn. An argument over food turns violent with a waitress on the receiving end of punches to the face.
As soon as I was going to like confront him and tell him you're gonna go to jail, he hit me as soon as I was walking through the door.
What did he do? He punched you in the face?
He did.
It all starts with an upset customer throwing a bunch of flyers at this waitress at Randy's restaurant in North Miami, because he was waiting too long for his food.
He punched me really hard, so I fell.
This 22-year-old mom says she was just trying to earn a living to support her baby when this guy got so upset.
I'm shocked because, you know, it's 2021. You know, people know their consequences for the actions.
Yeah, as if that were going to help. This guy, the demon in him, he came in to get his food. He could not get it. That guy's pissed off. You know, device 09. Anyway, that guy came in over there, did pissed off, and then it's like people always trying to say, okay, well, we're in 2021. Why there is still racism? Why is there? Because you've been watching too much hidden media. You've been watching too many conspiracy theories telling you things are going to get back to normal. Everybody, no racism exists. God doesn't exist. Do whatever the hell you want to do until reality come knocking in your door. Or in this case, in your face.
You can see the commotion in the restaurant, and it goes outside and it gets worse. So I understand you're still frightened, and that's why we're not showing your face. Mm-hmm. But this is all over because he didn't get his food?
Yes.
Cops are looking for this guy in his white Maxima. You can see the suspect walk to his car and employees following him. The victim actually took video of her attacker taking off. Notice how he backs up so she wouldn't get his license plate.
He keep kicking my daughter.
So he kicks her.
Kicks my daughter and punched my daughter while she was on the ground.
Okay, those are the Haitians that live down there. I know those people, trust me.
While she was on the floor. Yep.
As her mom, how do you feel?
I cannot even express how I felt, because imagine you have your kids go to work and then for things like that to happen to her, it's just horrifying.
All this over food. The victim's mom saying it's ridiculous. You don't expect a beating when you go off to work.
You haven't seen nothing yet. All praises to the Most High.
So they get their supply from New Jersey, and this New Jersey vendor can't even get the ammo from the manufacturing company because of the shortages that are going on.
Okay. So again, I, like I said before, I always say this, brothers, I do not like to copy any little small YouTuber, because it's a really difficult job. So this is our beloved sister, Lisa Cabrera. She brought this information that the Baltimore and other agency and other police agencies are facing an ammo shortages. As you can see, she put ammo with a zero here because YouTube will like demonetize. They'll do all sort of scumbag stuff. Now, why is that, brothers? Why is it there is a shortage? Anyway, we know for a fact this is a plague number one. I know sorrow for much needs shortages. Okay, there'll be a shortage for everything that those people need to live their life. Not us, but them. Why is that? Why is it like you know, those people can't even find bullets to do the work that they want to do. I read some of the scumbag comment trying to tell people, hey, don't be dismayed. They are buying those bullets and stuff so they can attack us. You silly little monkey. You think the enemy will put himself out there and let you know that he's buying stuff to destroy you? You think the enemy will put his intel out there, or intelligence, he'll put them out there for you to know when he's going to attack, what he's going to do? That is because what you're seeing here, it is real. They don't have any bullets. People are hoarding, and then they won't even use, they won't be able to use them. And if anything, the little one that they have to use, they will use it on themselves, because they'll be the one that will go to others, each other's houses, little bunkers and bug out location, kill each other to get the foods and ammos. Mm-hmm. You see, those people don't even have bullets or ammos or whatever. How are they going to bring Jacob Shobo? Do you know what kind of bullets you will need to kill billions of people? Hmm? So those, not only those guys are short on people to work for them, they're short on food, they're short on every single thing. Now they're short on ammo. This isn't conspiracy. This is real. The Mosai is the enemies, and he's doing this. He said, you were preparing Jacob's trouble to bring your sword upon my children again, because that's what the priest of Mahan told you. They never did tell you Jacob's trouble happened before, but they told you, like, oh, you guys going to woo them and stuff like that. He took your ammo away from you. You took them away. All right. So please see the video and watch the sister video. Please. All praises.
Simeon, detectives here at Area 2 are trying to figure out who killed him minutes after school let out.
Everybody knows that Simeon students come to JJ's after school. We go to Potbellies, we go to Walmart.
Just 20 minutes after they left school, someone opened fire on what's described as a crowd of students at the Chatham Market Shopping Center around the corner from Simeon. Police say around 2:40, people inside a black vehicle drove up and started shooting, hitting Jamari Williams in the chest, killing him. A backpack, hat, and sandals left behind as evidence.
I've been at Simeon all 4 years of my high school career, and I've lost multiple classmates every year. And it's just heartbreaking that we're only 4 weeks in school and another student is gone.
Ariana Williams, who's not related to the victim, found out about the shooting at practice for the pom-pom team and came to the scene with her mom.
I know somebody who was standing right by him when he got shot. And now I gotta call her and check on her to see if she's okay, because that's traumatic and that's not right.
Ariana.
So let me tell you something, brothers. Certain people, you can, they are books to me. You can read them. You can read a certain energy. Okay, certain things that are, bless you, bless be you, the seniors out there, bless you. You don't see those things that I'm seeing on social media, how those guys like this dude, how they are acting. Certain things they are doing with their fingers and throwing sign and talking tough. And then, you know, ended up, offended another group of people by saying slick things. You see, things like that are not random, okay? You must have done something to somebody. Everything is a disrespect in the world of social media. Yo, dude, I see you visiting my page. You didn't leave a comment. You didn't leave a like. You're a hater and stuff. You dissing me. Bam, 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 bam. Those are the two-thirds children, and the Most High is removing them. We cannot be emotional about this, brethren. We can't. At least I can't. I don't know about others that want to be emotional. That's up to you. I can't be. Because things like that happen. Those are the guys that don't listen. And their parents are in the church. And Satan is collecting soul out there.
Anna says Jamari was a member of the JV football team.
This was a good kid. A kid who wanted to.
Okay, so there you go. Let me enlarge this for you. There you go. Lo and behold. You know, we told you those are the Christian kids. Those are Christian, the people that go to church, and then the Satan is collecting the soul of those children. There you go. Pastor Donovan Price. The people, the parents pay the price. All praises to the Most High. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
play football.
And again, Simeon, the area name is Simeon. You know, the third son of Reuben, Simeon, and Levi, the second son of Jacob. Okay, Simeon. All right, Simeon was bad, man. Simeon and Levi destroyed a whole city by themselves.
Who looked forward to playing football at Simeon, but unfortunately, because of COVID, that was delayed.
Advocate and pastor Donovan Price says he met with Jamari's family this afternoon and learned the 15-year-old's dad was also shot and killed in the last year.
He was a kid who hoped to
move his mother. So the sword is in the family. See, things like that, brothers, when they happen, you should, if you have a family, brothers, like I told you before, if you have a family, I will tell this brief story. If you have a family, brothers, and the dad or somebody, a bunch of people in your, at least one or two people in your family or no more because of the sword, there is an issue in the family. There is a deep secret in the family. And you need to detach yourself from this family. For instance, for those of you who know, hang on, is that thing even recording? Because I've been talking for like, all right. So for those of you we know and you understand certain things that I repeat here, certain story that I brought here, and I showed you the mugshots and videos of my cousins and stuff. So in our family, brothers, we have what you call the righteous seed and also the wicked seed. And my family, because I'm the one speaking here, so to speak, and I have family members that committed horrible things, like my cousin up there in Boston, the one that saw the video. He ended up Jiffy Pop his girlfriend and the girlfriend's sister. Why? Because this girl that he knew, he certain men out there, if they saw a woman that they liked, automatically this woman liked them too. And they'll do all sort of things to make this woman like them. For instance, they'll spend a hell of a lot of bread on this woman. And most women will take this. A lot of women will take the bread and stuff. He was one of those non-talking dude. He was a kind fellow. He barely talked. He was a very, you know, soft guy. And then the girl didn't like him, and the girl went somewhere, I'm not quite sure, in Haiti. She got married to another dude, and she brought the dude back here with him. And she bought that guy. She was filling out the papers and all that stuff, and she took a picture with her and her husband and doing certain stuff, okay? And the sister... they were having an argument, and the sister said, "My sister do not want you. She already married. She has a husband now." And he said, "What?" And then she saw him the picture of them kissing. So he didn't say anything. He went home. He bought a ticket for Haiti. He said he wanted to talk to the girl to say congratulations, and then he met them in the house with a bag of popcorn. They were not aware of that, and he Jiffy popped them, both of them, cold-blooded, and he flee in Haiti. He spent somewhere around 5 years down there. The moment he showed up down there, people saw this. They saw it in his face. That's one cousin. Another cousin, he was, you know, going around and freeze people and so I get jacked him. And then it's they took four or five of them. I'll take the liberty to say seven. They put them, they tie their hand behind their back, they make them lay down face down, and then they took a 12 gauge shotgun and put them in the back of their head and Jiffy pop all of them. Okay? You got three brothers that gun like this. Okay, my little cousin, Donna, there was a shootout between the cops doing the president death, between the cops and the gangster. She got straight bullet, and then she got shot in the back of her head, and she fell on the floor. She pulled up her phone. She called her brother. She said, "Bro, I got shot in the head, okay? I'm dying, all right? I love you. I love mom and everything." And she died. They couldn't even get her. When she died on the asphalt in the street. They took her house. Once they dragged her body, her flesh was cooked. The son cooked her flesh. But we do in the family know that her father, he was not a righteous man. Okay, he did indeed, right in front of everyone, the whole neighborhood know it. He did took he did make somebody make transition because there was a rumor that this guy did something with his wife. A rumor. There weren't no proof, but he did this. So why am I saying this? I separate my, at least the most I did, he separated me from those folks, from those people. Okay, I have hardcore Christian in my family. I don't play with them. The so-called pastor, I told you, my auntie, I got one auntie, she's a pastor. She got a church and all that. Always want to argue stuff. I got cousins that are pastors. I don't mix with those people. And I keep telling you folks this, I despise them. I told the Most High straight up, I have family member, I hate them. If I need love to get into heaven, well, I'm going straight to hell because I don't love those people. They hate the Father. I hated them. They are wicked people. So in this family right now, brothers, as you can see, they invited this dude coming over here and saying few stuff. And they buying guns back, the Lord going to take. Nah, man, if you have a problem in your family, beloved brothers and sisters, they are being Jiffy Pop. Disconnect yourself from them. All right? That's all I had to say for this.
Out of the hood through football, had lots of dreams. All they could talk about was his dreams.
That's not right at all.
Yeah.
We're students, we're children.
That, well, hey, man, in the eyes of the Most High, you guys are criminals. Your forefather did not repent. They don't want to repent. And then this thing fall on you, just like our forefathers did. All praises.
An LA traffic jam of a different kind of sort. Hell, a record 70 cargo ships are waiting to get into the LA and Long Beach ports, and the shipments are carrying everything from furniture and electronics to holiday toys.
Okay, so record 70 cargo ships waiting to unload off port of LA, so they are waiting for clearance. What a number. Those shepherds think they can come over there and do all sort of things, and then they will flee with their Jesus. Yep, the 70 shepherd, the 70 weeks of Daniel. All praises, yes sir.
Well, officials say the delay is partly because there's a shortage of trucks and drivers to pick up the goods.
Why is that? Plague number one again, brothers, okay? Sorrow for much needs, shortages, okay? All right, shortages of workers, shortages of people, drivers, shortages of... Where are the truck drivers, man? You mean to tell me all those truck drivers quit trucking? For what? What is it? What is it? Why is that?
The Port of LA director says shipping traffic is also up 50% from pre-pandemic levels.
Uh-huh.
The American consumer's buying strength is so strong and epic that we can't absorb all this cargo into the domestic supply chain. That means you're not going to find the product you want as quickly as normal. If you're shopping for the holidays, start now.
Mm-hmm. So you got to work on it. Remember, it took like months for me to get my Peloton.
Oh, yeah.
All right, the economic logjam could continue until the end of 2022. The ports of LA and Long Beach handled 40% of the nation's imports.
So you heard that? 40%, 40 days fasting, 40 days for the years in the desert, 70, all those things the Most High is speaking to our private earbud and we hear him. This could last until the end of 2022. When we get in 2022. Oh, this could last until the end of 2023. Okay.
That's a lot.
Yeah, I was just in Long Beach. It was so full of these cargo ships just sitting here.
Okay.
Two of the...
All right. All praises, man. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, an Acres Homes neighborhood has had quite the eyesore along one street for years. The street is lined with trash, infested with rodents and insects. It has gotten so bad that one neighbor had enough and called Bill Spencer to get it solved. Bill Spencer is live now in that neighborhood. Bill, how bad is it?
Sophia, take a look at this ridiculous situation on Sandal Street and Acres Homes. I mean, this is more than, it's turned into more than just a dumping ground. I mean, this is a mountain of trash and dangerous debris, something the neighbors here have been dealing with for years. So they called me for help. In the historic Acres Homes neighborhood on Sandal Street, where people take pride in their homes, Carrie Gray, a hardworking U.S. postal worker, mother and grandmother, walks out the front door of her home that she's lived in for 47 years now and can't believe what she sees.
Actually, it doesn't feel like home living over here. It feels like it's a junk pile, a big trash pile.
Yes, right next to Carrie's home lies a massive mountain of trash, broken glass, building materials, old furniture, tires, busted up concrete, and countless ripped bags of stinking garbage. In essence, an ever-growing dangerous dumping ground that's cast a sickening pall over this quiet little street for more than 3 years now.
It's been horrible. The flies are horrible out here. The kids can't play out here. You cannot sit outside. It's just horrible out here every day.
In addition to the trash, neighbors complain about the flies, the cockroaches, snakes, and rats that live and breed inside this bacteria-filled mess.
Other state legislatures.
It's so bad, Carrie and her family spend most of their time indoors. And neighbors like Leonard Johnson say their many calls for help to the city of Houston have gone completely unanswered.
Yeah, because, of course, when they see our people in this neighborhood, I used to work for waste management. They're like, okay, well, sir, we have to put your order in, sir. We have to do this, sir. We have to do that.
When you call the city and ask for them to clean it up, what do they say?
We'll send somebody out.
They never do.
Never call. Never come.
Angry and disgusted about having to live with this horrible situation, that's when Carrie wrote to Spencer Solves It. And immediately after seeing this problem, I agreed to clean it all up for her.
Me and my neighbors definitely would.
You'd like to see that gone?
Yes.
It'll make you happy?
Of course it will.
And it's not just the people who live here. Look at the animals, the beautiful horses. They live right across the street from this horrendous dump site. We're going to clean all of this up all day long tomorrow with the help of two companies, 1-800-GOT-JUNK and Lansdowne Moody. That is a huge tractor supply company. They rent out and they sell tractors and lawn equipment, basically anything that moves dirt and grass. They do it, and we're going to be out here with...
Yeah, well, you know, just, you know, commercial and all that. Yeah, so you see, till this day, you see our poor folks, people that look like us, and I take the liberty saying they are people, they are living in this condition because the people in this city do not care. And you guys will pay for this, man. You will.
A coyote attacked the dog, killing him.
He gets up with me and I get up early.
In the brief moment, Bill Delaporte says he turned his back after letting his dog out around 5:30 Tuesday morning. The retired veterinarian says that is when his dog Rusty was attacked.
I started calling and walking, and I walked back over there and saw the tracks in the sand.
Fresh tracks, the Sanford grandfather says, tell the story of what happened to his Jack Russell Terrier mix.
And I said, coyotes, when I saw that, and fresh in the sand.
Fearing the worst, Delaporte says he rushed to check his motion camera in the backyard.
I got all the way back down there and I saw the tracks, and they were headed this way. And so I said, you know, whatever went in front of this camera, it was captured.
He was right. The camera caught this still image of the vicious attack, a coyote seen latching onto Rusty's neck before taking off.
We're so sad. We rescued him about 9 years ago.
Delaporte and his wife heartbroken over the loss.
He was the smartest and most loving little dog.
Now, Delaporte says he reported the incident to the FWC, and he says he is urging his neighbors to keep a close eye on their dogs, especially their cats. Live in the newsroom, Nikki Zizaza, getting results, News 6.
Wow, Nikki Zizaza. All praises to the Most High. You seen it, brothers. There is a massive amount. Again, this is plague number 3 right here. Pestilence among the cattle, okay. So there is a massive amount of coyotes, brothers. An insane amount of coyotes. They are going out there and they are killing animals. They are attacking people. They are attacking children. and then they are doing a lot of stuff. Okay, so all right, what is this? A video show suspect stabbing in Miramar. All right, let's probably let's close with this. This is 18 seconds. Is that what that is?
Identifying a suspected stabber in Miramar. Surveillance cameras caught him today walking through a shopping plaza along South University.
Okay, they didn't even show the stabbing video anyway. So, brethren, we are seeing a lot of things going on, man. A lot of coyotes are going on around the neighborhood and biting and killing and attacking people. This is Blake number 7. Wild beasts would be their grave. So those people are going to die at an alarming rate that the coyotes, those animals will be the one eating their dead bodies. This sickness that you see here, plus they haven't reported, last time I checked this thing was a month ago. I don't even want to check it anymore because they refuse to post the real things, okay? All right, so look at this. You don't even see the news about this anymore. They used to put the news over there, okay? Where's the overview? They used to have the overview thing. I don't know if it's something. There we go. They put them, they rearranged thing. They put overview on top now, okay? So when you click the overview, the news will pop up, okay? U.S. COVID death reach average of 1,900 a day, 1,900 a day. Biden pushes global plan to battle this thing as a national gaps widen. UK records 36,000 cases, and then seems like you people have the cure, yet you still suffer the same thing. Okay, so you can see this giant. Okay, you know, let me see if I can pull this. Oh boy. Okay, case overview. 219 million cases. Probably this is 219 million death. Okay, 4.5 million death. Okay, you can look at Africa. It's been a year and a half. You know, nothing really happened in there. Okay, look at South America. Okay, it's Brazil and so. But look at where you guys are now. You know, look at the fourth part. Okay, look at Europe. All right. So that's what that is, man. So, yeah, you know, you people are catching hell out there, you know, and they don't anyway. I don't care about that. They do not update this thing. They just make things up as they go. Beloved, it's 3:55. It's already 4 a.m. and that's previously when I was recording this video. I got a doctor appointment for my beloved mother at 8. So, got like at least 4 hours sleep. And then I'll see if I can get things going. Brothers, be at peace. There'll be no Jacob's trouble. Give the Most High glory and praises. Those people will not abuse, suppress, and oppress our people for that long. And then they will get away with it. And at the end of the 400 years, they get raptured. Or they get a do-over. They get another 400 years again. Or 7 years tribulation. Or 7 years tribulation. It's supposed to be for us, Jacob, but it seems like the entire world is going through a tribulation. You know, we were supposed to go through this, but it seems like the entire world is going through this tribulation. That is because it's the Gentiles' tribulation. Stay out of it. Fast, pray, repent, repeat. May the King reign forever.